जय राधे जय कृष्णा जय वृंदावा
जय कृष्णा जय वृंदावना
श्री गोविंदा गोपीनाथ मदन मोहन
श्री गोविंद गोपीनाथ मदन मोहन
श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धा
श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धना
कालिंदिया मोना जया जया महावा
कालिंदी जमुना जया जय महावाना
केशी घाट वंशी वट द्वादश कना
केशी घाट वंशी वट द्वादश कना
यहाँ सब लीला कोइलो श्री नंद नंद
यहाँ सब लीला कोइलो श्री नंद नंद
श्री नंद यशोदा जय जय गोपाल
श्री नंद यशोदा जय जय गोपाल
श्री राधे जय जय देनुवत सागा
श्री रामादि जय जय धेनुवत् सागना
जय वृष भानु जय कीर्तिदा सुंदरी
जय वृषभानु जय कीर्तिदा सुंदरी
जय पौर्णमासी जय आभिर नागरी
जय पौर्णमासी जय अभिरनागरी
जय जय गोपीश्वर वृंदावन माधव
जय जय गोपीश्वर वृंदावन माधव
जय जय कृष्ण सका भट्टद्विज राजा
जय जय कृष्ण सका भट्टद्विज राजा
जय राम घाट जय रोहिणी नंदन
जय राम घाट जय रोहिणी नंदन
जय जय वृंदावन वा से अतारा
जय जय वृंदावन वासी जत जाना
जय द्विज पत्नी जय नाग कन्या
जय द्विज पत्नी जय नाग कन्या
भक्ति तेरा पैलो गोविंद तारा
भक्ति ते जहारा पैलो गोविंद चरण
तेरा स मंगल दया जय राधा
श्या स मंडल जया जय राधा श्या
जय रातलीला सर्व मनोराम जय जय रातलीला
सर्व मनोराम
जय जय ज्वल रस सर्व रस
जय ज्वल रस सर्व रस सार
पर किया भावे ब्रजे ते प्रचार
पर किया भावे जहा ब्रज ते प्रचार
ते जानव पाद पद्म कोरिया स्मरण
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 दीन कृष्ण दास कहे नाम संकीर्तन
कृष्ण दास को है नाम संकीर्तन
श्री जानव पाद पद्म कोरिया स्मरण
श्री जानव पाद पद्म कोरिया स्मरण
दीन कृष्ण दास को है नाम संकीर्तन
दीन कृष्ण दास को है नाम संकीर्तन
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम राम राम
हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
जय जय राधे जय जय श्याम
जय जय राधे जय जय श्याम
जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम
जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम
कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम
कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम
कृष्ण बलराम जय वृंदावन धाम
कृष्ण बलराम जय वृंदावन
गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्याय गौर हरि बोल
हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नित्याय गौर हरि बोल
कलयुग पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की
जय
लीला प्रभुपाद की।
ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकम्। वंदेहं श्री गुरुः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द 17th चैप्टर ऑफ मध्यलीला चैतन्यचरितामृत। वी वर discussing about Lord Chaitanya in the Jharkhanda forest. Yeah? Yeah. 135? 35, just a minute. Huh? Yeah. So Mahaprabhu is going to the Jharkhanda forest. Let's proceed from where we left yesterday. So, that was a beautiful pastime. I didn't explain much, but I wanted to say a few words about it. So, this section starts here, first 20 verses we devoted for learning about one very important thing. What are the qualities of a personal servant? Swarup Damodar says to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the qualities of Balabhadra Bhattacharya. And also Mahaprabhu seeking permission from his devotees to go to Vrindavan. How he, early morning he left when all the devotees were asleep. And then by the request of the intimate devotees to take a Brahmana with him, so he accepted Balabhadra Bhattacharya. So we discussed qualities like snigdha, susnigdha, peaceful and very affectionate, and sadhu also, means very honest and non-duplicitous, and pandita means learned and scholarly, and arya, advanced in spiritual consciousness. So these were the qualities we discussed yesterday, and then proceeding further we discussed about Lord Chaitanya passing through the Jharkhanda forest. And the forest animals giving way, like packs of tigers and elephants and rhinoceros and boars. On the way, Balabhadra Bhattacharya was very afraid. And Mahaprabhu, one of the days, put his foot on a sleeping tiger and made him chant Krishna Krishna. Then he went to a lake where he performed his Gayatri and saw a huge herd of forest elephants, big elephants. So he sprinkled water on them and made them chant Krishna Krishna. So that Prabhupada said in the purport about Mahabhagavata devotee, he sees Pandita Samadarshana. He sees the Jiva in all the bodies. And he sees them all as Krishna's children. So therefore, because of such a vision, he is never afraid in dealing even with ferocious animals in such a friendly way. So all that we did. And then the last verse we read was this 34th verse. Some does, doe means a she deer. They also followed Lord Chaitanya. The Venu Gita, the gopis are talking about those deers. Blessed are these foolish deer, because they have approached Maharaj Nanda's son, who is gorgeously dressed and is playing on his flute. Indeed, both the does and bucks, they worship the Lord with the looks of love and affection, like that they are saying. So, one observation you will make in this section, that the difference between the living entities dealing with Lord Chaitanya and dealing with ordinary man, there's a big difference. A tiger or a lion or a cheetah may attack a man and tear him to pieces and may want to eat him up if the animal finds him not having any weapon in the hand. He may become a food for such animals very easily. On the contrary, the ferocious animals don't behave in ferocious way when they were dealing with Lord Chaitanya. They were very politely and gently moving aside to one side and giving way for Mahaprabhu to dance and sing and go ahead. That's one behavior. Similarly, the deers are coming close to Mahaprabhu and licking his lotus feet out of affection instead of the way the deers generally behave. The deers actually run away when they see us in sanctuary. Similarly, imagine you put your leg on the head of a tiger which is sleeping. So what do you expect it to do? The tiger actually got up and started chanting Krishna Krishna and dancing, which is actually an example of how the ferocious animals lost their ferocity due to the oceanic love emanating from Lord Chaitanya's heart. And that wave of love dominated their heart so much that they forgot their swabhavas. The swabhava arising from gunas, like rajaguna, tamaguna. They gave up their swabhava of the subtle body, mind. And they behaved purely as living entities, children of the Lord. Aham bija pradaya pita. Actually, Lord Chaitanya is the pita. He is the father, he is Krishna. So the animals, just like in Vrindavan, you hear about peacocks and deers and cows and calves and monkeys. They all actually are friendly with Krishna, including the trees also. In the same manner you find here, all the animals, they looked at Lord Chaitanya and they felt, oh, he is the same person. Krishna, earlier Krishna was Shyamsundar, now he has come as Gaursundar. So therefore we sang the song in the previous class, Dulai Dulai Gaura Chan. We had sung that because that is Lord Chaitanya coming to Vrindavan and meeting his own devotees. So, in this way, this section teaches a very important lesson to all the people of the world, that your Jharikhanda forest is a place where people may fear to go into because of such ferocious animals. So, material world is also compared to your forest. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, the Jadabharata section, he talks about the forest of material enjoyment. There, the description is given how the jiva who comes to this world is like a merchant who enters into this material world like a merchant entering forest to get gold and silver. So he goes deep, 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 deep into the forest. And then in one place he gets some gold and silver and everything he packs up. But then when he turns around, he forgets the route, how he came. And the more he tries to return, the more he gets into deeper and deeper jungle. And he hears the sounds of jackals and tigers and lions and, you know, hissing of the snakes and crickets and so many things like that. So, the jiva gets entangled in this forest of material enjoyment, like the Jadabharata explains. So, you will see that, Jadabharata also explains to Rahaguna and Shukadeva Goswami also explains to Parikshit elaborately about it. So, in this way, the forest of material enjoyment contains many animal-like people. People who are like tigers, who are like lions, who are like foxes and everything. It mentions that. So, here Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu didn't meet animals, meet people who behaved like animals. He actually met the animals. We also may come across sometimes in our life also, we see that people with dangerous propensities of politicking nature and bad-mouthing nature and people who are trouble creators to others due to the lust, anger and greed. Lust is the cause of all the gang rapes and everything. Greed is the cause of all the corruption and scandals, money scandals. And anger is the cause of all the criminal activities like murders and, you know, attacks and assaults and everything. So, but you will find that whether it be in humans, whether it be in animals, Lord Chaitanya had the potency and power to completely eradicate such impurities from the heart of the jivas and render them so pure that even a tiger would raise the arms and chant and dance. That's the main lesson here in this Mahaprabhu's visit to Jharkhand forest. Wherever Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu put his lotus feet, that place became Vrindavan. And all the animals forgot their malice or revengeful attitude or ferocious attitude, and they behaved like pure devotees. Yeah. So let us proceed with the 35th verse. Dahine vame dhvani, dahine vame dhvani shuni yaya prabhu sange.
Dahine vame dhvani suni yaya prabhu sange.
Prabhu tare angamuche shloka pade range.
Prabhu tare angamuche shloka pade range. Hearing the Lord's great vibrations, all the doves followed him left and right. While reciting a verse with great curiosity, the Lord patted them.
Danyasma mudha matayo api harinya yeta.
Danyasmi mudha matayo api harinya yeta.
Yananda nandanamupat.
Blessed are all these foolish deer because they have approached Maharaj Nanda's son, who is gorgeous, dressed, and is played on his flute. Indeed,
playing on his flute.
Indeed, both the doves and the birds worship the Lord with looks of love and affection.
That is from Bhagavatam 10.21.11. Gopis are speaking. Hena kale vyagratata aila pancha sata.
Yena kale vyagratata aila pancha sata.
Vyagra mrugi mili chale mahaprabhu rasata.
Vyagra mrugi mili chale mahaprabhu rasata. While Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was passing through the jungle, 5 or 7 tigers came. Joining the deer, the tigers began to follow the Lord.
Dekhi Mahaprabhu ra Vrindavana smriti haila.
देखी महाप्रभुर वृंदावन स्मृति हैला
वृंदावन गुणवर्णन श्लोक पड़िला
वृंदावन गुणवर्णन श्लोक पड़िला Seeing the tigers and the deer following him, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately remembered the land of Vrindavan. He then began to recite a verse describing the transcendental quality of Vrindavan.
यत्र नैसर्ग दुर्वैराः
यत्र नैसर्ग दुर्वैर्या
सहसन मृगादयः
मित्राणि वजितावास
दुतरुत्तरिषदादिकम्
वृंदावन इज अ ट्रांसेंडेंटल अबोड ऑफ द लॉर्ड देर इज नो हंगर एंगर और थर्स्ट देर दो नेचुरली इनमिकल ह्यूमन बीइंग्स एंड फियर्स एनिमल्स लिव टुगेदर देर इन ट्रांसेंडेंटल फ्रेंडशिप
वेरी फेमस वर्स इट इज Brahmaji saw the fierce animals and the human beings stay together, which means tiger is sitting right next to a man. And the man feeds the tiger one glass of milk. The tiger drinks milk and keeps quiet like a pussycat. That's the beauty of Vrindavan. Nobody feels hunger, anger or thirst there. Although naturally inimical means atra naisarga durvaira. I heard a similar verse in Garga Samhita also. शार्दूल बालकैर्यत्र क्रीडन्ति मृग बालकः लाइक दैट सो वर्स शार्दूल बालकैर् मीन्स टाइगर्स चाइल्ड एंड डियर्स चाइल्ड वर प्लेइंग टुगेदर इन वृंदावन ब्रह्मा सॉ दैट वेयरएवर देयर चिल्ड्रन देयर पेरेंट्स आल्सो विल बी देयर दैट मीन्स अ बिग टाइगर एंड बिग डियर आल्सो विल बी देयर बट दे हैव नो एनमिटी एट ऑल दे आर वेरी वेरी फ्रेंडली दे ड्रिंक वाटर टुगेदर इन यमुना बिकॉज ऑल द एनिमल्स इन गोलक वृंदावन they all are free from ferocity. They are mild like deers. So there is no enmity between them. Rather, there is a transcendental friendship, it is said. Yes. Ready? This is a statement from?
This is a statement from Srimad Bhagavatam 10.13.60. After stealing the cowherd boys and calves of the Sri Krishna, Lord Brahma kept them asleep and hid them. After moments, Brahma returned to see Krishna's
After a moment, Brahma returned to see Krishna's condition.
When he saw that Krishna was still busy with his cowherd boyfriends and animals and was not disturbed, Lord Brahma appreciated the transcendental opulence of Vrindavan.
Krishna Krishna kaha kari prabhu yave balila.
Krishna Krishna kaha kari prabhu habe balila.
Krishna kahi vyagra mraga nachite lagila.
Krishna kahi vyagra mraga nachite lagila. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, "Chant Hare Krishna, Krishna," the tigers and the deer began to chant Krishna and dance.
Yeah. Mahaprabhu made the tiger and deer dance and chant the holy name. Nache nache kunde vyagra gana mrugi gana sange.
Nache kunde vyagra gana mrugi gane sange.
Balabhadra Bhattacharya deke apurva range.
Balabhadra Bhattacharya deke apurva range. When all the tigers and the doves danced and jumped, Balabhadra Bhattacharya saw them and was struck with wonder.
So they were all dancing and jumping and calling out Krishna Krishna. Vyagramraga anyonye kare alingana.
Vyagramraga anyonye kare alingana.
Mukhe mukha diya kare anyonye chumbana.
Mukhe mukha diya kare anyonye chumbana. Indeed, the tigers and the deer began to embrace one another, and touching mouths, they began to kiss.
Amazing, huh? Tiger kissing a deer, have you ever heard of? Tiger only captures the deer by the neck and tears the deer to pieces. Far from such ferocity and fierce behavior, tiger is not only embracing, he is kissing out of love, affection, like a mother kissing a child. Kautuka dekiya prabhu hasite lagila.
Kautuka dekiya prabhu hasita lagila.
Ta sabake taha chadi aage chali gela.
Ta sabake taha chadi aage chali gela. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw all this fun, he began to smile. Finally, he left the animals and continued on this way.
Mayuradi Pakshigana Prabhure Dekiya.
Mayuradi Pakshigana Prabhure Dekiya.
Sange Chale Krishna Bale Nache Matahaya.
Sange Chale Krishna Bale Nache Matahana. Various birds, including the peacock, saw Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and began to follow him, chanting and dancing. They were all maddened by the holy name of Krishna.
That is the point. What made them? They had drunk the greatest nectar of the holy name, and that was like somebody is drinking honey. How you will feel? Like that, they all felt the joy of drinking the sweet holy name emanating from Lord Chaitanya's mouth. Having heard that, they became intoxicated in love. So they lost their other propensities, lower propensities. So like peacock, began to follow him, chanting and dancing. Hari bola bali prabhu kare ucha dvani.
Hari bola balu prabhu kare ucha dvani.
Vrikshalata prafullita sei dvani suni.
Vrikshalata prafullita sei dvani suni. When the Lord loudly chanted Hari bol, the trees and the creepers became jubilant to hear him.
And they became like refreshed. Like the trees started blossoming as soon as they heard Hari bol, Hari bol, Hari bol. And Mahaprabhu would say that the trees would bloom, bloom. Yeah. Purport?
The loud chanting of Hare Krishna mantra is so powerful that it can even penetrate the ears of trees and creepers. What to speak of those of animals and human beings? Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu once asked Haridas Thakur how trees and plants could be delivered, and the Haridas Thakur replied that the loud chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra would benefit not only trees and plants, but insects and all other living beings. One should therefore not be disturbed by the loud chanting of Hare Krishna, for it is beneficial not only to the chanter but to everyone who gets an opportunity to hear.
Sometimes people say, why are you guys disturbing? We're singing so loudly. Why do you come in the street and chant and dance so loud? So here is the answer. When one chants loudly, not only one benefits oneself, one also benefits other creatures, like the mosquitoes and the dogs and the cows and the bulls and the donkeys, horses, even in city. Similarly, Haridas Thakur said, any creature is fortunate to listen to the chanting of the holy name, including animals and birds. What to speak of them? Even mountains. When you say Hare Krishna, then the mountains would echo back. Mountains and trees, they would echo back. Hare Krishna, sound would come. Haridas Thakur told Mahaprabhu, my dear Lord, it is not an echo. When we chant Hare Krishna, they are reciprocating back, calling the holy name. So in this way, the holy name is the supreme purifier of all living entities, even though they may be apparently dull. A tree is considered to be one of the dull creatures, which just stands in one place. Even if you pinch a tree, only your finger will pain. You know, but such a dull creature, when the trees heard the holy name, they blossomed. They became very refreshed.
जारिकंडे स्थावर जंगमाचेयत
कृष्ण नाम दिया कैला प्रेमेते उन्मत्त
Thus all living entities in the forest of Jharikhand, some moving and some standing still, became maddened by hearing the holy name of Lord Krishna vibrated by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The great forest of Jharikhand is a great tract of land including Atagada, Dhinakanala, Angula, Lahara, Kianjara, Bhamala, Bhunai, Gangapura,
Bhamada, Bhunai, Gangapura,
Chota Nagapura, Yashapura and Saraguja. All these places which are covered with mountains and jungles are known as Jharikhand.
ये ग्राम दिया याना यहाँ करे न स्थिति
In all the villages through which the Lord passed and all the places he rested on his journey, everyone was purified and awakened to the ecstatic love of God.
Just like Mahaprabhu South India visit, isn't it? Whomever the Lord saw, whomever he made them chant, whichever village he stayed, all people who were fortunate to come in contact with him, they all became enlightened and enlightened and purified, up to the point of ecstatic love, awakening.
Keha yadi tara mukhe sune krishna nama
tara mukhe ana sune tara mukhe ana sabe krishna hare bale nache kande hase
paramparaya vaishnava haila sarva deshe When everyone heard the chanting of the holy name from the mouth of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and someone else heard this chanting from that second person, and someone again heard this chanting from the third person, everyone in all countries became a Vaishnava through such disciple succession. Thus everyone chanted the holy name of Krishna and Hari, and they danced, cried and smiled.
So Mahaprabhu spirit in South India also. He would embrace one man, give him the holy name, then he would go to his village, then jump from that village to the neighborhood village. This is how it is spread.
The transcendental potency of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, here and explain. First, the holy name is vibrated by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When someone hears from him directly, he is purified. When another person hears from that person, he also is purified. In this way, the purification process is advanced among pure devotees. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is the supreme personality of Godhead, and no one can claim his potency. Nonetheless, if one is a pure devotee, hundreds and thousands of men can be purified by his vibration. This potency is within every living being, provided he chants the Hare Krishna Mahamantra offenselessly and without material motives. When a pure devotee chants offenselessly, another person will become a Vaishnava, and from him another Vaishnava will emerge. This is the parampara system.
See, this is a secret of preaching, Prabhupada is saying. So, very important points are mentioned in the purport here. Hare Krishna mantra is so transcendently potent that it purifies everyone. Lord Chaitanya is Supreme Lord and no one can claim His potency. Nonetheless, Prabhupada says, if one chants offenselessly and without material motives, thousands will become Vaishnavas by such pure vibration. This is the parampara system. So, many times we think, preaching means you just give classes or you prepare and talk something. I'm supposed to say something. Or sometimes people think, you gather a crowd of people, you give them some prasad, you do some kirtan and chant and dance and they go away. Actually, if our preaching is effective, it will make committed devotees. Many people who take to the chanting of the holy name will not be able to leave the sangha of devotees. They will want to come again, then again and again. Eventually, they will say that, I don't want to leave the devotees only. They will become perfect followers of Lord Chaitanya. Eventually, you will see them. Gradually, their hairstyle will change. They will have Hare Krishna cut. They will have tilak. They will have kantimala. They will have dhoti kurta. They will have saris. They will be doing service. They will get initiated. They will get chakan initiated. And they will be entering more seva. And they will preach. And they will bring more people. And they will become a member of the inside family of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. They will accept Lord Chaitanya as their life and soul. They will accept the holy names as their life and soul. And they will become property of Krishna. So, this is the effect of very powerful chanting of the holy name. Offenseless chanting without any ulterior motives. If we can preach like this, that's real preaching. Otherwise, sometimes we get an illusion that we have preached to a lot of people. Especially when you arrange some big program, one pandal program or one time program. When a big crowd comes, we think, oh, we have attracted such a big crowd. But what is this big crowd? This crowd comes like waves of ocean coming to the shore and then returning back. They come, chant, dance, take prasad, they go away. They are just, maybe we can say they are well-wishers or appreciators of our program. But they are not people who are willing to become committed to the chanting. So, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, what is preaching? Preaching means, he says that, giving people faith in the holy name. Our preaching means awakening Krishna in the hearts of the people to whom we are preaching to. Our preaching means making people Krishna's devotees. Not just inspiring them with little prasad and sending them away. They have to become inside people of Krishna. So, in this way Mahaprabhu's chanting was so offenseless and so free from material motivations. It sprung from the heart. And that influenced animals and humans and all types of, living bodies. That's a beauty.
Yadyapi Prabhu Loka Sangatera Trase.
Yadyapi Prabhu Loka Sangatera Trase.
Prema Gupta Karena Bahirena Prakashe.
Prema Gupta Karena Bahirena Prakashe. The Lord did not always manifest His ecstasy. Being afraid of great assembly of people, the Lord kept His ecstasy concealed.
So, tears springing from His eyes, hair standing on end, bodily color changing and body trembling in ecstasy. All this Hashtasattvika Vikar Mahaprabhu will not show everywhere because He thought that some people may watch it and imitate His ecstasy, cheating the rest of the people. So Mahaprabhu controlled Himself, controlled His ecstasy.
Tatapi Tara Darshana Shravana Prabhave.
Tatapi Tara Darshana Shravana Prabhave.
Sakala Deshera Loka Haila Vaishnave.
Sakala Deshera Loka Haila Vaishnave. Although Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did not manifest His natural ecstatic love, everyone became a pure devotee simply by seeing and hearing Him. Sri Rupa Goswami has described Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as Mahavadanyaya Avatara, the most magnificent incarnation. Although Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is not physically present now, simply by chanting His holy name, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadhadara, Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda, people throughout the world are becoming devotees. This is due to the ecstatic chanting of the holy name of the Lord. It is said that a pure devotee can see the Lord at every moment, and because of this, he is empowered by the Lord. This is confirmed in the Brahma Samhita
5.38.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu appeared 500 years ago, but it cannot be said that now the potency of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra is less than it was in his presence. By hearing Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu through the Parampara system, one can be purified. Therefore, in this verse it is said, Tatapi tanre darshana shravana prabhave. It is not that everyone is able to see Krishna or Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu physically, but if one hears about him through the books like Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita and through the Parampara system of pure Vaishnavas, there is no difficulty in becoming a pure Vaishnava, free from mundane desires and personal motivations.
Correct. So in this way, Prabhupada says that, Prabhupada often used to say that, you know, some people say, oh, if only I heard Bhagavad Gita from Krishna directly, how nice it will be. And Prabhupada would say, even now you can hear from Krishna. How? By adopting the mood of Arjuna. Even now, if you read Bhagavad Gita, Krishna will directly speak to you. If you adopt the mood of Arjuna, like that you would say. Similarly, Mahaprabhu's mercy can be tapped even now, provided we very sincerely approach the chanting of the holy name.
Gaudabhanga Utkala Dakshina Desha Giya.
Gaudabhanga Utkala Dakshina Desha Giya.
Lokeranistara Kaila. आपने ब्रह्मिया
लोकेर निष्ठार कैल आपने ब्रह्मिया. इन दिस वे श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु पर्सनली टूर्ड बंगाल ईस्ट बंगाल ओरिस्सा एंड द सदर्न कंट्रीज एंड यू डिलीवर्ड ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ पीपल बाय स्प्रेडिंग कृष्ण कॉन्शियसनेस.
सो ही कवर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु पर्सनली टूर्ड टू बंगाल ईस्ट बंगाल ओरिस्सा एंड द सदर्न कंट्रीज. So, in this way, Mahaprabhu is traveling and preaching. Actually, he has two programs. One program is to go to Vrindavan and relish the sweetness and beauty of Vrindavan. But along with that, side by side, you can see that wherever he is going, he is preaching and setting a very beautiful, attractive example, and everybody is inclined to become Krishna devotees.
Mathura yai bare chale. आसीन झारखंड
मथुराय भारे चले आसीन झारखंड
दिल प्राय लोकतः परम पाषंड
दिल प्राय लोकतः परम पाषंड. व्हेन श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु केम टू झारखंड ऑन हिज वे टू मथुरा ही फाउंड दैट द पीपल देयर वेर ऑलमोस्ट अनसिविलाइज्ड एंड वेर डिवाइड ऑफ गॉड कॉन्शियसनेस. द वर्ड भिल्ला रिफर्स टू ए क्लास.
हियर प्रपोज विल एक्सप्लेन अबाउट दिस. भिल्ला प्राय means bhils. Who are these bhils? Low people. Prabhupada explains here. I read the purport.
The word bhilla refers to a class of men belonging to bhils. The bhils are like black Africans and they are lower than sudras. Such people generally live in jungle, and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had to meet them.
This is nothing to criticize about any particular group of people. Actually, different people have different natures. Like a tiger has its nature, pussycat has its nature, cow has her nature, and a fox has its nature. So, sometimes it's advantageous to know about the nature of different animals. You may keep a pussycat in the lap, but you may not keep a tiger's child in the lap. You may not keep like that. So, when you are going through the forest, the bhils would, would be living there, and they are like outside the Varnashrama system of Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya and Shudra. So, then there are other groups like Nishada, Chandala, Yavana, Mlecha. Many other groups are there outside the four. They are called Antyajas. But although the Vedas categorize them as outside the four, the Vedas don't criticize them downplayed or ignored, or they are not respected. They are recognized as a class, and therefore their needs are different. Their needs are different than the others. So, Mahaprabhu came across these people. नाम प्रेम दिया कैला सभार निस्तार
नाम प्रेम दिया कैला सभार निस्तार
चैतन्य गूढ़ लीला पूजिते शक्तिकार
चैतन्य गूढ़ लीला पूजिते शक्तिकार
श्री
चैतन्य महाप्रभु गेव इवन द भील्स एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू चैंट द होली नेम एंड कम टू द प्लेटफॉर्म एस्टेटिक लव
दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ आवर मूवमेंट वी डोंट सी हु इज हु every living living body is a every living being is a child of krishna that's how we see like that verse is kirata hunaandra pulinda pulakasha abhira shumbha yavana kashadaya ye anye cha papaya tapashraya ashraya shudyanti tasmai prabhu vishnave namaha this verse talks about kirata hunaandra pulinda pulakasha abhira shumbha yavana kashadaya which means the people who are turkish people who are jains people who are Turkish, people who are Chinese, people who are from Mongolia and many other places like that, Greece, Germany and all those people. All of them can chant Hare Krishna and become purified. That's the point. They can get ecstatic love. Read further, finish it.
Thus he delivered all of them who has the power to understand the transcendental pastime. Who has the power to understand the transcendental pastimes of the Lord?
So nobody is barred from becoming a Krishna devotee.
As evidence of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, we are experiencing that the people of Africa are taking to Krishna consciousness, chanting and dancing and taking prasadam like other Vaishnavas. This is all due to the power of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who can understand how this potency is working all over the world.
When Prabhupada went to Nigeria, as Grace Brahmananda Prabhu was there, I think, is it Nigeria? Nairobi. So Prabhupada saw that many Hindus were there in the temple. Prabhupada asked Brahmananda Prabhu, where are the Africans? I wanted Africans to come to temple. He said, Prabhupada, Indians are more easy to preach here. And they also come to temple. They come and give donation also very well. Prabhupada said, I didn't send you for this. And Prabhupada said, open the temple doors, he said, and call all the Africans to come. And they said, Prabhupada, they don't come easily. Prabhupada said, open the doors, let's do loud kirtans. One of the reasons Prabhupada started loud kirtan, everybody joined. Many Africans came and they danced together very, very, jumping very high, very enthusiastically. Then Prabhupada said, I'll speak in English, you translate into Swahili, local language. And then many, many Africans started joining the temple and becoming a member of the community. Prabhupada said, just see. So, in this way you will see that the Prabhupada wanted to show that the holy name is for everybody. It is not only for some class of people like Brahmanas or some section. Everybody can chant holy name and become a devotee.
Vana deki brahmahaya yai vrindavana.
Shaila deki manehaya yai govardhana.
Shaila deki manehaya yai govardhana.
Any forest that Mahaprabhu saw, he thought, what is this forest?
Vrindavan.
Any mountain he saw, he felt this mountain is
Govardhan.
That was his consciousness when he was traveling.
When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu passed
Yaha nadi deke taha manaye kalindi.
Yaha nadi deke taha manaye kalindi.
Mahaprema veshenache prabhu pade kandi.
Mahaprema veshenache prabhu pade kandi. Similarly, whenever Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saw a river, he immediately accepted it as a river Yamuna. Thus, while in the forest, he was filled with great ecstatic love and he danced and fell down crying.
So, now somebody may say, Mahaprabhu's Krishna, how is he misunderstanding or how is he mistaking? So, the pure devotee's mistake, apparent mistake, which may we may think is a mistake, is looking at ordinary river and thinking it to be Yamuna, seeing ordinary mountain and calling it Govardhan. Or is calling ordinary forest as Vrindavan. But this, we may think he is mistaken, he is not mistaken, we are mistaken. Because the ultimate reality is Vrindavan Dham, imperishable Dham, eternal Dham, eternal home for all. So he is seeing that everywhere. Unlike the ordinary conditioned souls who are always looking for sense gratification and they are forgetful of Vrindavan Dham. So,
पतेयाइते भट्टाचार्य
शाक मूल फल
पते आयते भट्टाचार्य साके मूल फल
यहाँ यही पायन तहाँ लयन सकल
यहाँ यही पायन सहान लयन सकल Along the way, Balabhadra Bhattacharya collected all kinds of spinach, roots and fruits whenever possible.
Yeah, from 57 to 81, Balabhadra Bhattacharya's service pleases Lord Chaitanya. That is the section now. The previous section, it was, first part was delivering the tigers and deers and elephants and all. And the second part was about Mahaprabhu going to the remote villages and all. Bhils and other people, inspiring them in Krishna consciousness without seeing that who is lower class, who is higher class, it is open to all. And now this 57 to 81, this section is very important also. Balabhadra Bhattacharya service pleases Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. That's the section.
ये ग्रामे रहे न प्रभु तथाय ब्राह्मण
ये ग्रामे रहे न प्रभु तथाय ब्राह्मण
पांच सात जन आसी करे निमंत्रण
पांच सात जने आसी करे निमंत्रण Whenever Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visited a village, a few brahmanas, five or seven, would come and extend invitations to the Lord. Some people would bring grain and deliver it to Balabhadra Bhattacharya. Others would bring milk and yogurt, and still others would bring ghee and sugar.
Different people, when simply by looking at Mahaprabhu, they became eager to serve him in some way. So somebody brought milk, somebody brought dahi, somebody brought ghee, sugar. They would come and give it to Balabhadra Bhattacharya. Please feed the Lord.
Yahan vipranahi tahan shudra mahajana.
Yahan vipranahi tahan shudra mahajana.
Haasi sabhe Bhattacharya kare nimantrana.
Haasi sabhe Bhattacharya kare nimantrana. In some villages, there were no brahmanas. Nonetheless, devotees born in non-brahmana families came and extended invitations to Balabhadra Bhattacharya. Actually, a sannyasi or a brahmana will not accept an invitation extended by a person born in lower family. However, there are many devotees who are raised to the platform of brahmana by the initiation. These people are called Sudra Mahajana.
That means they may not be born in brahmana families, but now they have become Vaishnavas now.
This indicates that one who is born in a non-brahmana family has accepted the brahmana status by initiation. Such devotees extended invitations to Balabhadra Bhattacharya. A Mayavadi sannyasi will accept an invitation only from a brahmana family, but a Vaishnava does not accept an invitation from a brahmana if he does not belong to the Vaishnava sect.
See, Mayavadis are very particular only about a Vaidika brahmana. One who studies the Vedas and one who is born brahman, by birth brahman, by blood relationship is brahman. Whereas Vaishnava sees that, he may accept a prasadam in a brahmana's house who has taken second initiation, although he belongs to a lower caste. For example, many devotees in ISKCON, they come from some certain caste which is non-brahmana caste. But when they get first initiation and second initiation, another great Vaishnava may not mind going to his home, taking prasad. Because now that he has become a second initiated brahmana devotee, he is as good as any typical born brahmana, or he is even better also. Prahlad Maharaj says in one shloka, he says, Viprad Vishad Guna Yutat Aravindanabha Pada Aravinda Vimukha Chvapacham Varishtham Manyetadar Pitamano Vachane Hitartha Pranam Punati Sakulam Natabhuri Manaha. My dear Lord, your devotee Chandala is far superior to a non-devotee brahmana. Whether he says. Because the devotee Chandala fellow who became a devotee now, he can deliver his whole family members, he is saying, we are preaching to them. Whereas a brahmana, he can't deliver even himself. How will he deliver others, he says.
However, a Vaishnava will accept an invitation from a brahmana or a Sudra Mahajana if that person is an initiated Vaishnava. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself accepted invitations from Sudra Mahajanas. And this confirms that fact that anyone initiated by the Vaishnava Mantra can be accepted as a brahmana. One can accept an invitation from such a person.
You see, once some devotees' parents came, and they come from a Brahmin family, by birth, Brahmin by birth family. So then the devotee took them to another home of another Vaishnava devotee who speaks the same language, you know. Generally in Pune we do that. If somebody speaks the same language as your parents, they feel very happy that somebody is, they connect very easily. So then they went to the home. Oh, very nice. They met each other, spoke in mother tongue. They were very happy. Then they fed prasadam to them. And after eating the prasadam on the way back, the father asked the son, you took us to that family. They speak very nice, our own language. I hope they are Brahmins only, correct? He said. And then he said, yes, they are Brahmin initiated and then ISKCON. He said, no, tell me, what is their caste? Then he told them the name of the caste of that family. And father became angry. He said, what is this? He belongs to a lower caste and we are Brahmanas. How did you take me to their house to eat? It's how horrible it is. He got really angry. And son was trying to tell them, why are you seeing the Jati Buddhi? You know, he is actually a great soul. He is a Vaishnava devotee. You know, he is leading a pure life, follows four regulated principles. No meat-eating, no gambling, no intoxication, no illicit sex. He is first initiated now, he is second initiated now. He is also a Brahmin. He is not Brahmin by birth, but he is a Brahmin by qualities. Still, this boy's father couldn't understand. Because some people actually, you know, cannot. Therefore, generally, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also followed the norm. Wherever he went, he ate in Brahmana's homes to avoid social misunderstanding and people rejecting his teachings. Therefore, he ate in Brahmana's homes. But occasionally, like here, you find when he was going through forest and certain villages, Mahaprabhu was willing to accept in a Vaishnava's home, although the Vaishnava may not be a born Brahmana. भट्टाचार्य पाक करे वन्य व्यंजन
भट्टाचार्य पाक करे वन्य व्यंजन
वन्य व्यंजने प्रभुर आनंदित मन
वन्य व्यंजने प्रभुर आनंदित मन बलभद्र भट्टाचार्य यूज्ड टू कुक ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ वेजिटेबल्स गैदर्ड फ्रॉम द फॉरेस्ट एंड श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु वाज वेरी प्लीज्ड टू एक्सेप्ट दिस प्रिपरेशन
नो कंप्लेंट्स फ्रॉम चैतन्य महाप्रभु ही डिडंट से व्हाई इज द प्रसाद सो सिंपल. You know, you are just collecting some things from the forest and making for me. And the Mahaprabhu didn't expect a big feast, especially in such travels. Whatever was provided, he was so satisfied and grateful. He saw it as prasada. Duye chari dinera anna rakhe na samhati.
Duye chari dinera anna rakhe na samhati.
Yaha shunyavana loker nahi kavasati.
Yaha shunyavane loker nahi kavasati.
Taha sei anna bhattacharya kare paka.
Tahe sei anna bhattacharya kare paka.
Phala mule vyanjana kare vanya nana shaka.
Phale muke vyanjana kare vanya nana shaka.
Phala mule vyanjana kare वन्य नाना शाखा
फले मूले व्यंजन खरे वन्य नाना शाखा बलभद्र भट्टाचार्य यूज टू कीप ए स्टॉक ऑफ फूड ग्रेन दैट वुड लास्ट फॉर 2 to 4 days वेयर देयर वेयर नो पीपल ही वुड कुक द ग्रेन एंड प्रिपेयर वेजिटेबल्स स्पिनेच रूट्स एंड फ्रूट्स कलेक्टेड फ्रॉम द फॉरेस्ट
जस्ट सी सो इन दिस भट्टाचार्य देयरफॉर Nityananda and others had suggested Mahaprabhu that you should have one assistant with you. You know, because he gathered food grains, he would keep it for 2 or 4 days. And where there were no people, complete forest, he would cook those grains and prepare some vegetables, roots and fruits and collect it from the forest. Paramasantosha prabhura vanya bhojane.
Paramasantosha prabhura vanya bhojane.
Mahasukha panaye. दिन रहे न निर्जने
महासुखा पान ये दिन रहे न निर्जने द लॉर्ड वॉज ऑलवेज वेरी हैप्पी टू ईट दीज फॉरेस्ट वेजिटेबल्स एंड ही वॉज इवन हैप्पियर वेन ही हैड एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू स्टे इन अ सॉलिटरी प्लेस
सो महाप्रभु फॉर हिम यू नो एज रिगार्ड्स टू प्रसाद ही सीज़ इट्स कृष्णास मर्सी वट एवर इज अवेलेबल ही इज हैप्पी. There is one shloka comes to my mind, a very beautiful verse. Nishchintita, it says that. Sada nama laiva yata labhete santosh krishna bhakt yaita acharya kare bhakti dharma posh. Then somewhere else it comes. Very beautiful verse. Sadaa Naam Alive. Always chant the holy name. Yata Labhate Santosh. Whatever comes of its own accord, be happy with that. Don't complain why it's not there. Why only one sabji? Why not two sabji today? Why only simple rice dal? Why not pulao kadhi? Don't complain what is not there. Whatever is there, accept it happily, gratefully. So, and then he's saying, this is one thing. And Sadaa Naam Alive. Always chant the holy name. If you do these two things, he says, Krishna will solidly maintain you, he says. Such a person will be solidly maintained by Krishna. Always he is chanting the holy name and satisfied with whatever Krishna sends. Bhattacharya seva kare sneha yaiche dasa.
Bhattacharya seva kare sneha yaiche dasa.
Tare vipravahe jala patra bahirvasa.
Tare vipravahe jala patra bahirvasa. Balabhadra Bhattacharya was so affectionate to the Lord that he was rendering service just like a menial servant. His assistant Brahmana carried the water pot and garments.
Yeah. So there are two people now with Mahaprabhu, correct? No? Bhattacharya is cooking and there is one more assistant Brahmana who carries the water pot and garments. Yeah. Nirjarete Ushnodake Snanatina Bhara.
Nirjarete Ushnodake Snanatina Bhara.
Dui Sandhya Agnitapa Kastera Apara.
Dui Sandhya Agnitapa Kastera Apara. The Lord used to bathe three times a day in the warm water of the waterfalls. He also used to heat himself morning and evening with a fire made with limitless wood.
Nirantara Prema Veshe. Nirjane gamana.
Nirandhara prema vishe nirjane gamana.
Sukhanubhavi prabhu kahena vachana.
Sukhanubhavi prabhu kahena vachana. While travelling in this secluded forest and feeling very happy, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made the following statement.
Shune Bhattacharyami gelana bahu desha.
Sune Bhattacharyami gelana bahu desha.
Vanapate dukera kaha nahi pailesha.
Vanapate dukera kaha nahi pailesha. My dear Bhattacharya, I have travelled very far through the forest and I have not even slightly received any trouble.
Krishna Kripalu Amaya Bahuta Kripa Kaila.
Krishna Kripalu Amaya Bahuta Kripa Kaila.
Vanapate Ani Amaya Bada Sukha Dila.
Vanapate Ani Amaya Bada Sukha Dila. Krishna is very merciful, especially to me. He has shown his mercy by bringing me on this path through the forest. Thus, he has given me the great pleasure.
Purve Vrindavana Yaite Karilana Vichara.
Purve Vrindavana Yaite Karilana Vichara.
Mata Ganga Bhakta Gane Dekiva Ekabhara.
Mata Ganga Bhakta Gane Dekiva Ekabhara. Before this, I decided to go to Vrindavan and on the way see my mother, the rivers Ganges and other devotees once again.
Bhaktagana Sange Avashya Kariba Milana.
Bhaktagane Sange Avashya Kariba Milana.
Bhaktagane Sange Laya Yabhe Vrindavana.
Bhaktagane Sange Lana Yabhe Vrindavana. I thought that once again I would see and meet all the devotees and take them with me to Vrindavan.
Yeta Bhavi Gauda Deshe Karilo Gamana.
Yeta Bhavi Gauda Deshe Karilo Gamana.
Mata Ganga Bhakte Deki Sukhi Haila Mana.
Mata Ganga Bhakte Deki Sukhi Haile Mana. Thus I went to Bengal and I was very happy to see my mother, the rivers Ganges and the devotees.
Bhaktagane laya tabe chalilana range.
Bhaktagane laine tabe chalilana range.
Lakshakoti lokataha haila ama sange.
Lakshakoti lokataha haila ama sange. However, when I started for Vrindavan, many thousands and millions of people gathered and began to go with me.
Sanatana Mukhe Krishna Ama Shikhaila.
Sanatana Mukhe Krishna Ama Shikhaila.
Taha Vigna Karivana Pate Laya Aila.
Taha Vigna Karivane Pate Lana Aila.
So from Sanatana's mouth I learned What he learned from Sanatan's mouth? Krishna taught me a lesson through Sanatan's mouth. That by making some impediment, he has brought me to Vrindavan on the path through the forest.
Kripa rasa mudra dina hina daya maya.
Krishna kripa vina kona sukha nahi haya.
Krishna is an ocean of mercy. He is specially merciful to the poor and fallen. Without his mercy, there is no possibility of happiness.
Bhattacharya Alingiya Tahare Kahila.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then embraced Balabhadra Bhattacharya and told him, "It is only by your kindness that I am now so happy."
See Mahaprabhu's gratitude here. So two things you will observe here in this section. One is Mahaprabhu satisfied with even simple things. So you will see certain devotees also like that. Give them little khichdi, they will be so grateful. Thank you Prabhu, such a wonderful mercy. Such a wonderful prasadam. It's memorable Prabhu. Great Prabhu, wonderful Prabhu. Just what wonderful. Sabji got over, chapati got over. Only some little khichdi and that too, it's not very hot. It was made a couple of hours ago. But he will say, no Prabhu, it is so, soft. And so delicious. There are people are very grateful for little prasad if you give them. And you give them one place in the corner to sleep, they put a chatai or even sleep on the floor, keeping their hand. They will say, Prabhu, thank you for accommodating me. Yesterday evening I came, I got to attend the morning program, I am so happy. Such a nice accommodation. What accommodation? Just in one corner you give them a floor, bhumi to sleep. So, some devotees you will find this, that they don't have any expectation for accommodation or prasad. Whatever is provided, they accept. Because their heart is flooding with Krishna consciousness. They don't expect anything materially great. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu here, that is one thing, satisfaction. And second thing is his gratitude to Balabhadra Bhattacharya becomes evident here. It is only by your kindness that I am now so happy, Mahaprabhu is saying.
तेहो कहे न तुमी कृष्णा तुमी दयामय
तेनु कहे न तुमी कृष्णा तुमी दयामय
अदम जीवमी मोरे हैला सदया
अदम जीवी मुनि मोरे हैला सदाया बलभद्र भट्टाचार्य रिप्लाइड माय डियर लॉर्ड यू आर कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ एंड देयरफॉर यू आर मर्सीफुल आई एम अ फॉलन लिविंग एनिटी बट यू हैव बेस्टोड ए ग्रेट फेवर अपॉन मी
मुनि चार मोरे तुम्हें संगे लया हाइला कृपा करी मोरे हाते प्रभु भिक्षा कैला
Balabhadra's attitude, what he is saying.
Sir, I am most fallen, yet you have brought me with you. Showing great mercy, you have accepted food prepared by me.
I am very fallen, I don't deserve to cook for you. Your associates are like Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Acharya, who are such great souls. But nevertheless, you took me with you. You agreed to take me with you as your servant. That itself is a great mercy upon me. And you agreed to accept the prasadam cooked by me.
Adhama kakere kaila garuda samana.
Swatantra ishwara tumi swayam bhagavan. You have made me your carrier Garuda, although I have no better than a condemned crow. Thus, you are the independent personality of Godhead, the original Lord.
See, you made me your carrier Garuda, although I am no better than a condemned crow. This is the attitude of whom?
Balabhadra
Bhattacharya. So, you are independent Lord, somehow you chose me, it's my good fortune, like that he says.
Mukam karoti vachalam.
Mukam karoti vachalam
langayate girim
pangam langayate
yat kripatamaham vande
paramananda madhavam. The Supreme Personality of Godhead has the form of Satchit Ananda Vigraha, the transcendental bliss, knowledge and eternity. I offer my respectful obeisances unto him who turns the dumb into eloquent speakers and enables the lame to cross the mountains. Such is the mercy of the Lord.
This is from Bhava to Deepika commentary, on Srimad Bhagavatam course. So, this is the last verse of this section.
In this way, Balabhadra Bhattacharya offered his prayers to the Lord. By rendering service unto him in ecstatic love, he pacified the Lord's mind.
In this way, he expressed his heart to Mahaprabhu back. By rendering service to him in ecstatic love, he rendered service, loving service. He never felt the service like a burden in the forest. He never minded the difficulties.
Finally, the Lord arrived with great happiness at the holy place called Kashi. There he took his bath in the bathing ghat known as Manikarnika.
So now this is taking us to next section. But the previous section will require a little more discussion, which I will do in the next class, because Mahaprabhu's attitude while traveling to Vrindavan and Mahaprabhu's gratitude to Balabhadra Bhattacharya and Balabhadra Bhattacharya's response to Mahaprabhu's grateful statement is very important. So we will talk a little more about it. This 57 to 81 verses. So, after we do the discussion, then we will go to Lord Chaitanya going to Varanasi. Shri Prabhupada ki, Shri Sajjan Sartamrita ki,
Jai.
Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki,
Jai.
Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.